Good morning, students. Today we'll study about the rules of Reed diagram, how the Reed diagram is constructed. So today we'll study about the some rules for the Reed diagram in concave and convex mirror. So in the previous class we have studied about the spherical mirror and some of the terms of the spherical mirror, like as principle of axis, center of curvature, aperture, yes, pole of mirror, focus, focal length. We have already studied in the previous class. Today we will study about the rules how we draw the ray diagram in concave and convex mirror. What are the rules should be remembered while we are constructing the diagram? So today we will study about the rules and be careful and watch it properly. Don't skip these videos. Okay, don't skip these videos. Look the videos carefully and try to do in your home also. So now I will let's start. Now here is the ray diagram. What is that ray diagram? Ray diagram means the diagram which shows the information of image. What is which gives the information about the image? That is called what? Ray diagram. Ray diagram is what? As you know, the image is formed when in the concave and convex mirror, the image is formed, and that image information about that image that the ray diagram is drawn. So what are the rules? What are the rules for the drawing the ray diagram in concave mirror? First of all, let's read the word concave mirror. After that, we read the convex. So let's start the first rule. What is the first rule is saying? First of all, try to understand, then write. When the incidence ray is parallel to the principle of axis, when in the incidence ray, as you know, here this is a what? Concave or convex? Concave. Because inner surface is reflecting side and outer side is polished. This is the concave mirror. So here is the principle of axis. What is this? Principle of axis. And this is the center of curvature. Yes, this is the focus. This is the focus. And this point is the principle of what? Pole of mirror. This is the pole of mirror. First rule is what is saying? When an incidence ray is parallel to the principle of axis, then what happened? When an incidence ray is parallel to the principle of axis, when an incidence ray is parallel to the principle of axis, after the reflection, the incidence, after the reflected ray, it always passes through the focus. First rule. When the incidence ray is parallel to the principle of axis, the reflected ray always pass through the focus. First rule. Once again I am saying, when the incidence ray, what is incidence ray? The ray which comes out from the source of light, that is the incidence ray. When an incidence ray is parallel to the principle of axis, at that time, after the reflection, reflected ray must be passed through the focus. First rule. Second rule. When an incidence ray pass through the focus, then what happened? Now I will show you another concave mirror. As you know, this is the principle of axis. This is the center of curvature. This is the focus. This is the pole of mirror. Yes. Second rule. When the incidence ray is passing from the focus, when an incidence ray passing through the focus, now incidence ray is passing through the focus, then after the reflected, it pass parallel to the principle of axis. It always reflected to the what? parallel to the principle of axis. Now this incidence ray when passing from the what focus, then it must be parallel to the principle of axis. Second rule, when the incidence ray is passing from the focus, then after the reflections that ray must be parallel to the principle of axis. This is the second rule. Okay, first rule is when the incidence ray is parallel to the principle of axis, after that striking it returns back to the focus. And another is when the incidence ray now passing through the focus, that must be parallel to the principle of axis. Now third rule is what is when. Now let's talk about the third rule. What is third rule? Rule number three is what is saying. This is a center of curvature. This is a focus. And rule number three is what is saying, when an incidence ray are passing from the center of curvature, when an incidence ray is passing through the center of curvature, then what will happen? Then after the striking the mirror, it return back in the same medium, in the same line. It does not go through the focus or pole of mirror. Yes, when it goes through the center of curvature, then it returns back to the center of curvature. इसको अर्थ क्या भायो कि कुनै रे center of curvature बाट जान्छ भने त्यो reflection गरिसकेपछि फेरि center of curvature बाट return आउँछ. Rule number three. Rule number four. What is our rule number four? Rule number four is rule number B or 4 in a concave mirror. Here, this is the center of curvature, this is the focus, and this is the what? Principle of pole of mirror. Now, when an incidence ray pass through the pole of mirror, then what will happen? Incidence ray goes to the pole of mirror. Now, then what is the angle formed between the incidence ray and the principle of axis? Yes, that is same as it returns back by making the same angle of incidence. That is sine i by sine r. It means both sine I is equal to R. It means when an incidence ray is passing through the pole of mirror, strikes the pole of mirror, it forms an angle between the principle and incidence ray. The same as it forms an angle between the principle axis and the reflected ray. इसको अर्थ के भयो कि कुनै वाला incidence ray pole of mirror मा गएर ठोकियो भने, स्ट्राइक गर्यो भने, जति एंगलले principle of axis र incidence ray ले बनेको हुन्छ त्यतिकै एंगलमा त्यो रिफ्लेक्टेड ब्याक हुन्छ. यस, सो देयर आर फोर रूल्स. पहिलो रूल के थियो, कुनै इन्सिडेन्स रे प्रिन्सिपल अफ एक्सिसबाट प्यारलली छ भने त्यो फोकसबाट पास हुन्छ भनेर स्ट्राइकिङ ठोकेर. दोस्रो रूल मैले के भनेको थिएँ कि यदि कुनै रे फोकसबाट पास गरिरहेको छ भने स्ट्राइक गरिसकेपछि त्यो प्रिन्सिपल अफ एक्सिससँग प्यारलल हुन्छ. तेस्रो रुल, कुनै रे इन्सिडेन्ट रे सेन्टर अफ कर्भेचरबाट गरिरहेको छ भने रिफ्लेक्सन गरिसकेपछि त्यो सेम मिडियम, सेम वे, सेम लाइन इट कम्स, भनेको त्यही बाटोबाट त्यही लाइनमा रिटर्न आउँछ. चौथो मैले भने कि कुनै इन्सिडेन्स रे पोल अफ मिररमा गएर ठोकेर आयो भने त्यो जति एंगलले बनाएको हुन्छ प्रिन्सिपल अफ एक्सिस सँग त्यतिकै रिफ्लेक्टेड रे भने एंगल भने पास हुन्छ सो देयर आर द फोर रूल्स अफ द रे डायग्राम इन कन्केव मिरर नाउ आई विल शो यू द इन अ कन्केव मिरर बाय कीपिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट इन अ डिफरेंट पोजीशन बाय कीपिंग द व्हाट ऑब्जेक्ट इन अ डिफरेंट positions so don't skip this videos let's watch continue now let's keep the let's find out the position and the nature of image formed by a concave mirror yes what is position and the nature of image formed in a concave mirror now the size location and the nature of the image formed by a concave mirror will keep the what one by one the object is should be in the what in the ray diagram the ray diagram now first of all let's keep the object beyond the sea it means beyond the center of curvature then what its nature where its location what is its size this we'll talk now let's see this is a concave mirror What is this? Concave mirror. This is the principle of axis. This is the center of curvature. This is the focus. This is the pole of mirror. Okay. Now we have to keep the object just beyond the center of curvature. It means we should keep the object. बियोन्ड द सेन्टर अफ कर्भेचर भनेको सेन्टर अफ कर्भेचर भन्दा अलि पछाडि राख्ने अब्जेक्टलाई कहाँ राख्ने सेन्टर अफ कर्भेचर भन्दा पछाडि देन व्हाट विल हैपन टु इट्स नेचर नाउ द इमेज द इन्सिडेंस रे फॉल्स ऑन द व्हेन ऑन द मिरर नाउ After when this incidence ray is parallel to the principle of axis, यदि principle of संग parallel छ भने त्यो कहाँबाट पास हुन्छ focus बाट focus yes now another incidence of ray should be passed through the focus rule number 2 यदि अर्को incidence ray फोकस बाट पास हुन्छ भने त्यो के हुन्छ प्रिन्सिपल अफ एक्सिस सँग के हुन्छ प्यारलल हुन्छ इट शुड बी प्यारलल टु द प्रिन्सिपल अफ एक्सिस इट मीन्स वेयर द इमेज इज फॉर्मड हियर 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 बिटवीन द सी एंड एफ The image is formed between the center of curvature and the focus. It means the nature, we have to write the nature. The question is when the object is kept at beyond the center of curvature, where is the image is formed? What is its size? What is its nature? So all three things we have to write there. Where the image is formed? First of all, image is formed in say between the center of curvature and the focus. Image is formed between C and F, center of curvature and the focus. Now, another. Size, location, location is finished. Location is finished. Size, what is its size? Its size is diminished. What is its size? Its size is diminished. Its size is diminished. Now, when the size is diminished, now nature. What is it? Another is nature. What type of the nature this is? This is the real and inverted. Real and inverted. real inverted. Means the image is real but it is inverted. You have seen it is diminished. Diminished means small size. Small size. The when the object is kept beyond the center of curvature, the image is formed between C and F. Its nature is real, inverted, and diminished. So our question is, what is our question? When the object is kept beyond the center of curvature, then what is its size, location, nature, then what we have to write? We have to write its size is what? Diminished. Its nature is real and inverted. Location is where? It is formed between the C and F. So easy. Yes? The first question is, in examination of point of view, how this question will be asked? This type of question. Then, in examination, the concave mirror is given. Here is the central curvature is also given. Focus is given. And principle of pole of mirror is also given. Then, the diagram is, the object is kept at the beyond the center of curvature. Then there will be a question in what? Complete the ray diagram and also write its size, location and nature. Complete this diagram and also write this nature, size and location. Then we have to draw the same diagram and write same things. Write, draw the same diagram and write the same nature. Image is formed between C and F, diminished, real and inverted. Now, second one. Now, second questions. Now, second point. When the object is kept at C, what is? Object is kept at C. It means when the object is kept at the center of curvature, then where the image is formed, what is its size and what is its nature? Now, this is the concave mirror. This is the principle of axis. This is the center of curvature. This is the focus. And this is the pole of mirror, which is denoted by P of O. Now, our question is, when the object is kept at C? Now the object is kept at C. And one thing I want to say, so imagine these things. The distance between C, F and F, P must be equal. One thing, don't forget this one. The size of what? C, F. It must be equal to F, P. Means, from the center of curvature and focus size to 2 meter, then must be focus to the principle, must be 2 meter. Otherwise, your ray diagram will be wrong. So, remind these things. Galti na karne yo. Center of curvature of focus ko length jati ke huncha, tati ke focus dekhi principle of pole of mirror ko lambai hunu parcha. Natare yo ke huncha, ray diagram timro purai galti huncha. So, don't forget these things. You center of curvature when the object is kept. Now, it passes through the parallelly to the principle of axis. Now, it passes through the, I will give it to you, camera, focus one. And another way, when it passes through the principle of axis, it must be passed through the where? Parallel to the principle of axis. It means, when the object is kept at the C, the C means just the image is formed at the C. No, C my object like what you? Then image will come on you. Same on you. Same map on you. CA map on you. Center of curvature map on you. Yes, here is the image is formed. Now, what is? Object image is formed at C. Image is formed at C. Number two, it is a real inverted and same size. Same size. Jatro object thiyo tetre image bancha. Kema jab object lai center of curvature rakhincha. जत्रो ऑब्जेक्ट हुन्छ त्यतिकै साइज हुन्छ तर त्यो इन्भर्टेड हुन्छ रियल हुन्छ र त्यो कहाँ बन्छ सीमै बन्छ यो कुरालाई ध्यान दिने थर्ड रूल नम्बर थर्ड वन इज व्हाट व्हेन द ऑब्जेक्ट अब हामी सार्दै जाउँ है जस्ट पुश दिस ऑब्जेक्ट्स व्हेन द ऑब्जेक्ट इज केप बिटवीन सी एंड एफ C and Y. C and Y ma bichma rakhe bhane ke hunch. Now we have to keep this object in between C and Y. Let's see. Ke hunch herne. This is what? Which mirror? Concave or convex? Concave. This is center of curvature. This is focus. This is pole of mirror. Now the object is kept in between C and F. C and F. Then same things. The image is parallel to the principle of axis and a parallel journey. Passing through the focus. And it passing through the focus. And another way, when it goes to the mirror, it must work. It forms here. It means when the object is kept at C and F, the image is formed beyond the center of curvature. कहाँ? Beyond the center of curvature. तुम्हें और इधर ही वाला यहाँ center of curvature यहाँ बनो. Size where image is formed. Image is formed. Beyond the C. Ramanya, beyond the center of curvature. Now, it is real. It is inverted. And it is magnified. What is magnified? Highly, or we can say magnified. Magnified, it means the size of the object and the image size is as the comparison to the object size, the image size should be large. भनेको जत्रो object थियो त्यो भन्दा ठुलो image बन्छ कुन जब object लाई center of curvature र focus को बीचमा राखिन्छ पुरा बुझिरहेछौ do you understand it? When the object is kept at C and F, the image is formed beyond the center of curvature. Now, another is when the object is kept at focus. यदि हामीले focus में रख दिया नहीं क्यों? I will showing you one by one. Okay, so you must look the video carefully. Don't skip the video. Look the carefully. When the object is kept at F. Now, in the focus, then what happened? Let's see. This is C, this is F, and when object is kept at F, then what happened? It passes through the principle of and the parallel passes through the principle of focus. Now, another ray which must be passing through the center of curvature and return back in the same, and the image is formed at infinity. Where the image is formed? इमेज इज फॉर्म्ड एट इन्फिनिटिव. यदि हामीले अब्जेक्टलाई घरमा फोकसमा राखिदियो भने इमेज कहाँ बन्छ, इमेज इन्फिनिटिवमा बन्छ. र त्यो इमेज कस्तो हुन्छ, त्यो इमेज रियल हुन्छ, इन्भर्टेड हुन्छ र हाइली म्याग्निफाइड हुन्छ, धेरै ठुलो हुन्छ. द्याट इज द हाइली म्याग्निफाइड. देन वेयर इमेज इज फर्म, इमेज इज फर्म एट इन्फिनिटिव. इमेज इज फर्म एट इन्फिनिटिव. यस, इट इज रियल, इट इज इन्भर्टेड एन्ड हाइली म्याग्निफाइड. हाइली म्याग्निफाइड, द्याट इज हाइली म्याग्निफाइड. विशाल, ठुलो हुन्छ. के भन्दा? अब्जेक्ट भन्दा. अब अर्को छ, जब हामी अब्जेक्टलाई पोल अफ मिरर फोकसको बिचमा राखिदियो भने के हुन्छ? अब हामी के गर्छौँ, फोकस एन्ड प्रिन्सिपल अफ एक्सिससँग राखिदिन्छौँ भने के हुन्छ? नाउ लुक द भिडियो केयरफुली एन्ड ट्राई टु वाच इट केयरफुली. When the object is kept at F and C, F and P, it means focus and pull of mirror. Now I will keep you. This is the C and this is the F and this is the P. When object is kept at P, then what happened? Now these things must be understood. Look carefully. What will happen? When it passes through the, it must be passed through the where? Focus. So the ray of the light must be passed through the focus and it strikes another ray of light. It goes through the where? Through the focus. The image is formed behind the mirror. Where the image is formed? Behind the mirror. The object is formed. Image is formed behind the mirror. Image is real or virtual? Virtual. Virtual. Inverted or erect? Erect. Erect and magnified. Large. When the object is kept at the F and P, the image is behind the mirror. Virtual, erect and large. And last one is, when the image is comes from infinity, जब इमेज इन्फिनिटीबाट आउँछ, जब इन्सिडेन्स रे इन्फिनिटीबाट आउँछ भने के हुन्छ? All of you note it carefully and try to understand. When the object is comes from the infinitive, now when the object is kept at infinitive, infinitive, then what will happen? This is C and this is F. And when the object is comes from the infinitive, like this, from the infinitive, it passes through the focus. It passes through the focus. When it parallel to, it passes through the focus. Focus, it means all the image is formed at the focus. The image is formed at the focus. It means जब कुनै ray of light इन्फिनिटीबाट आउँछ भने त्यसको इमेज कहाँ बन्छ, फोकसमा बन्छ. त्यो इमेज कस्तो हुन्छ, रियल हुन्छ, इन्भर्टेड हुन्छ र हाइली डिमिनिस्ड हुन्छ, धेरै सानो बन्छ. र कहाँ बन्छ, फोकसमा बन्छ. फेरि कुरा सुन्ने, जब इन्फिनिटीबाट रे अफ डायग्राम रे अफ लाइट आउँछ भने त्यसको इमेज कहाँ हुन्छ, कल्के मिररमा? focus na. So only this month today we have to draw and you have to practice more and more in your home. If you have any problem, contact in my website, okay, or in the school's site. Thank you.